first surprise is that you talk about my birthday. I'm glad that nobody talk about my age. Because newspapers, the cabinet decided 3 years ago when I became 1970-something, that from then on we must stop after saying 67 or 57, 67, and we stop there. Otherwise, it would have been 77. So since that day, I said, don't ever use my age. But young people are saying we're too old. So therefore, since I'm younger looking than them, don't announce my age. Just say happy birthday. So, Dr. Kamadi, thank you, all of you, thank you for already thinking of my old age. I'm honored to be here to officiate at the inauguration of the new container terminal at the port of Walvis Bay. And before I go on about the greetings of the President of China, thank you very much. We already met about 5 times, one-on-one. That's why I remembered my birthday. Also, from home front, you may wonder how come foreign diplomats and leaders are recognizing him. But I have a letter from Founding Father, again wishing me well on my birthday, long letter. Then yesterday I also got a letter from Comrade Ifeketina Bohamba, Lucas. Very nice letter. So, 3 presidents already wish me well. So, rest of you, don't pray too much, Pastor. But we just wish me good health, which I have. So thank you very much indeed. Last week, when I was here for the inauguration of the Zimbabwe Dry Port, I took the opportunity to check on the progress and ensure whether work would be completed in time for today's inauguration. I was doubtful. But I was assured that indeed it would be completed. And I'm proud that today was the inauguration of the new terminal. Namibia has become one of the countries where major container terminals across the continent. Let me therefore express my appreciation to the current and previous directors of boards, management, and staff of Namibia Port Authority for the strategic initiative to expand the container terminal at the port of Walvis Bay. This milestone is yet another indication that as a country, we continue to make great strides towards collectively achieving our developmental objectives as outlined in Vision 2030 strategic plan, which is buttressed by our national development plans and fast-tracked by the Harambe Prosperity Plan. It is therefore no coincidence that the completion of the new container terminal coincides with the Silver Jubilee marking the reintegration of Walvis Bay and the offshore islands into Namibia. On the occasion celebrating the reintegration, the founding president and father of the Namibian nation, Comrade Sam Shafushina Nyoma, put it fittingly that, and I quote, from today, Walvis Bay becomes a strategic gateway to the emerging markets of Southern and West Africa, as well as those of Latin America, unquote. Thus, today is a culmination of a long cherished vision of transformation of Walvis Bay. From a predominantly fishing harbour inherited at reintegration into Namibia into an express hub to international markets. Namibia has now joined countries such as Australia, Brazil, Dubai, and Netherlands in the utilization of reclaimed land for port expansion. Thus, the completion of the container terminal expansion puts us on a firm trajectory towards realizing our dream of transforming Namibia into an international logistic hub. Namibia is linked to neighboring countries through the various transport corridors, and we must strive to capitalize on this immense investment by harnessing the vast potential of our Southern African Development Community, neighbors that have no immediate access to the ocean. We have since coined a term of sea-linked countries. Some said land-linked, but I changed when I was here and said sea-linked countries to refer to what we previously referred to as landlocked countries. The new container terminal now gives us the additional capacity to serve both local and regional requirements. I have taken note of the fact that as an added advantage, a dedicated cruise liner berth and marina breakwater were constructed as part of this project. This strengthens our capacity to attract tourists to our shores so that Namibia can benefit from a growing tourism industry. Here we have a city to which tourists can travel by road, rail, air, and sea. This is a feat worthy of celebrating. However, let us not use these achievements as an excuse to sit back. We must seize this moment of growth and development to vigorously pursue and fast-track the development of Walvis Bay waterfront so that we can further elevate our attractiveness as a business and leisure destination.